thinking about this person. A follow-up now to Rush Limbaugh's revelation that his lung cancer is terminal.
From the moment you get the diagnosis, there's a part of you every day, okay, that's it, life's over. You just don't know when.
Limbaugh says his challenges are actually no more special or different than anybody else's. It's a humble way to put it. Dr. David Spigel is the chief scientific officer and director of lung cancer research at Sarah Gannon Research Institute. Dr. Spigel, tell me a little bit more about this certain type of lung cancer and if this is surprising given the nature of Rush Limbaugh's diagnosis.
Hey, good morning, Robin. Thanks for having me. I don't know a lot of the details about Mr. Limbaugh's care, and obviously my thoughts go out to him and his family. Lung cancer can present in different ways. There are certain types, and without knowing, you know, which type he has, I'll just say in general, we approach lung cancer by trying to understand not only what it is, but where it is. And understanding where it is helps us figure out the kinds of things to do to help patients, whether it's surgery, or medicines in their body, like chemotherapy, or some new therapies, like what we call immunotherapy, therapies designed to boost their immune system.
So he's 69 years old. He said his treatment's been adjusted in hopes that it'll slow the cancer for as long as possible. How do you adjust things? Things like what?
Well, you know, for any patient with cancer, especially lung cancer, you're trying to understand if what you're doing is working. And so you're always seeing folks and assessing the status of how they're feeling, how the cancer is responding to the therapy you're giving. We use visits. We use pictures like CT scans to help figure that out. And so I imagine what's happening is, again, with not knowing a lot about the details, but a change has occurred. Perhaps cancer is not responding to the first therapy. And so a decision was made, you know, to change directions. I tell patients all the time, this is expected. We expect that we're going to have to change course. It's like making a turn in the road, but we're going to find a new path. And hopefully Mr. Limbaugh and other patients who go through that will find benefit from that new path.
For other people who are going through cancer treatments here, what new discoveries or treatments are on the horizon that may give hope?
Well, I think there are a lot of reasons to be hopeful, and gosh, lung cancer, research in lung cancer is just accelerating at a tremendous pace. We've talked before about advances in all of cancer, but just to go back to some things I mentioned before, not only have we had amazing advances in surgeries and radiation approaches and things I think patients and families are used to hearing about, like chemotherapy, but the big advances more recently have been the development of therapies, often pills that patients can take that specifically target the cancer and why it's growing, the signals that make it grow. And the other big advance has been something called immunotherapy. And we've talked a little bit about this. This is the idea of using your body's immune system to fight cancer. And in lung cancer, really over the last 8 or 9 years, this has been probably the biggest advance and is helping really thousands of patients around the world.
You know, it's been said that purpose and passion may have the biggest impact on how a patient is doing. So this is a man who certainly loves doing his job and was back on after having some time off here. How much of an impact may that give somebody in terms of going on?
Well, Robin, you bring up a good thing. Not only do we have these kind of scientific advances, but the support system we have around us, with our family, our friends, our coworkers, as you put out, and also our own personal drive, you know, things that we're excited about doing, whether it's our work or being around our families or important events, I do think play important roles in helping us push forward, because when you're fighting, you know, something that is just weighing on you every day, it can make you lose that hope. But I think with that support system, with that drive, it gives a lot of people that extra boost that helps in addition to all the scientific advances that we discussed.
His listeners obviously mean a lot to him. And so what a frank discussion that he had with them, and our thoughts are with him. So Dr. David Spigel, thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Robin.